Governor, thank you very much for taking the time to speak with us today.
My honor.
We are thrilled that you're visiting India. And this is a historic visit. You're the first New Jersey governor to go on a trade mission to India. And you're building on two successes, recent successes, one to Germany and one to Israel.
You bet.
So based on that, what are your primary objectives for this trade mission and what outcomes are you expecting?
So very good to be with you.
Thank
you. We are very excited about this trip. We have among the largest Indian populations of any American state. Mm-hmm. We have enormous investment from Indian corporates. The culture runs deep in this state. The community is one of our most important. So to be able to go to India with a delegation is an incredible honor. I'd say several objectives. We're there for 7 days mm-hmm. across six cities. So we're moving around a fair amount here.
Hectic schedule.
We figure we'll get our money's worth from being there. It will be, I think, heavily in commerce and business. And we understand, by the way, a trip like this has to work both ways. Mm-hmm. So it's not just what's good for New Jersey, but also what we can contribute and what's good for India. So it'll be heavy in commerce and business, education, higher education in particular, workforce development, apprenticeship programs, culture, some government mm-hmm. exchanges. And we'll focus on the industries, on the business part of this, which is really the bulk of it, the majority of it, on the industries where we are both, on the one hand, prioritizing and where India and Indian corporates have a significant presence. So life science, technology, telecom, film and television, those would probably be the big ones.
IT also included?
IT, without question, without question. And we've got some of the biggest Indian companies already in New Jersey, so I want to thank them for their presence, mm-hmm. maybe try to convince them that we'd love even more of their presence, and also to the companies that are not here yet, or institutions of higher education that may not have a relationship with a New Jersey university, that New Jersey is a place they should consider.
Sure. What have you learned from your previous trips to Israel and Germany that you would apply here?
So let me say this, and this is, I'm very happy and very excited about. This is not my first trip to India.
Yeah.
I lived in Asia for 3 years and went to India in the late 1990s mm-hmm. about once a quarter. But I haven't been back for 20 years.
Okay.
So I suspect a lot has changed.
A lot of things have changed.
So I'm very excited to get back. I think in the trips to both Germany, where I served as the U.S. ambassador, and Israel, which has an enormous amount of depth of relationship with New Jersey, I think a couple of things. One is, I mentioned this earlier, a trip like this has to work for both sides,
sure.
not just for one side. Secondly, particularly in the innovation economy, mm-hmm. Tech, telecom, life sciences, there's an enormous amount of commonality with India certainly, but with Germany and Israel as well. So it's no accident that those countries have been picked among our first state visits. Thirdly, I want to make sure folks hear loud and clear the New Jersey story, and not just on its own, but maybe see it in contrast to some of the noise around the American story these mm-hmm. days. So we were ranked as the number one public education system in America, something we're really proud of. That resonated deeply in Germany and Israel. I suspect it will in India. I mentioned our leadership in STEM and innovation. Another great attribute of our state is we lead the nation in participation mm-hmm. of our school children in taking foreign language classes. Yep. I think that says, even beyond our diversity, an enormous amount about our mindset, our openness, mm-hmm. our international mindset. I want folks to know that we understand this is a big world and that we're proud to participate and play in that world.
But you're also taking this trip at a time when trade relations between India and the U.S. are not very optimal. The Trump administration has imposed new trade tariffs.
Yep.
India has retaliated, and immigration, there are stricter rules now.
Bet.
So broadly speaking, how does that impact your trip, but more in terms of foreign direct investment coming into this state?
I suspect none of it helps.
Yeah.
The good news, knock on wood, is that so far the presence has stayed high and even grown from the Indian corporate sector. I am not a tariff fan. I'm not a closed market mm-hmm. fan. Mm-hmm. I'm an optimist as well that I think this gets to a better place sooner than later.
Okay.
My big concern always as it relates to opening up trading relationships is to make sure our workforce does not suffer as a result, that we understand what the consequences are, particularly unintended consequences. That would go for visa pools and applications and allowances as well. I believe, you know, our unemployment rate in New Jersey is 3.3%. Yeah. It's the lowest it's ever been. It's lower than the American rate. I'm proud of what we have to offer here. I don't think this is an either or. Either you employ your current indigenous workforce or you have folks from the global workforce coming here. I think you can do both.
Mm-hmm.
I believe in that. In fact, New Jersey has historically led the nation in doing just that. So these are challenges. Some of this is above my pay grade. I don't set trade policy. I don't set immigration policy. We speak loudly to each. I also think, as I say, I'm an optimist. This, I think, works its way through the system, I hope, and believe sooner than later.
Okay. You've touched on some of this, but we are in a hyper-competitive scenario where all states are vying for foreign direct investment.
You bet.
What is New Jersey's core value proposition, or what do you think differentiates New Jersey?
You betcha. I'd say two things. Good value for money. Mm-hmm. In other words, we're not the cheapest place to live or do business, but you get a rich basket of stuff back for that. Number one education system in America, number one in physics, number two in chemistry, as I mentioned, number one in foreign language participation. Save the Children ranks as number one in America to raise a child. The safest hospital system in America, a location second to none between New York and Philadelphia. So talent heavy, location heavy. Those are two huge weapons for us. But I'd also say values. So not just good value for money, but I'm proud of the values.
Yeah.
We stand up for our immigrant communities. We stand for sensible gun safety.
Mm-hmm.
We stand for sensible immigration policies. We protect the LGBTQ community. We stand up on behalf of women's health and women's rights within healthcare.
Sure.
So we stand strong for the environment. We're the densest state in America. So I think it's both good value for money and good values that are the real magnets that keep people here or attract them to come here.
You mentioned trade is a two-way street.
Even a mission like this is a two-way
street. There has to be reciprocity,
you
right?
Betcha.
So what are you expecting from the Indian government? You know, there's a new government in place, and the second Modi regime, a new finance minister in place. What do you expect from the Indian government in terms of reciprocity, ease of doing business, that sort of thing?
Government of India to the government of the United States of America, that's beyond my pay grade at the moment. So I'm more focused on what is the relationship between New Jersey on the one hand and any of the states or cities that we're visiting, the corporates, the interlocutors in that respect. And to me, I think it's sharing of best practices. I mentioned education, higher education. We're bringing a handful of the most senior representatives from our universities with us. That's a classic area where we can have 1 + 1 = 3 results. Workforce development, apprenticeship training. We've got now, I signed into law last year, the nation's most progressive film and television tax credit.
Yeah.
So we're gonna be sitting with the entertainment industry, Bollywood, and trying to find ways that relationship can deepen.
Absolutely.
So I think those are examples where I think you know, we don't go into something like this thinking this is all for us, all selfish.
Yeah.
We want to
see a
two-way street and a sharing of success. Yeah.
Talking about the Indian community here in New Jersey, sizable Indian population, as you know, the diaspora is growing. How do you view their contributions to the Garden State?
Enormously important. Business, both big and small, by the way. We're talking about large
and small
businesses, but boy, I'll tell you, the presence of the Indian community in our small business community is quite striking. So it's commerce and business, it's culture. I visited on several occasions the temple that's being built in Robbinsville.
Sure. One of the largest in the world.
One of the largest in the world. I think both countries celebrate a pluralistic society, and that's an important commonality. I know we do in New Jersey, and that means a lot. Cultural impact, educational, increasingly leadership in government, both in elected and appointed positions. I'm proud to have the most diverse cabinet in the history of our state, including a Sikh American as our Attorney General, Gurbir Grewal, as an example of that. So the contribution of the community is enormous. It is one of, if not the fastest growing communities we have in our state. And we're incredibly proud of that.
Okay. Just switching gear to the US political scenario, 20-odd Democratic candidates for the 2020 elections. Any advice to them to rise above the fray?
I think it's shrinking. It may have crossed under 20
under
at this
12,
point,
yeah.
But it's still a lot. I think be true to yourself. Remind folks what the American proposition is, what our values are. I co-officiated at an LGBTQ wedding the other night, and I chose when one of the spouses, who's a very dear friend of mine, I said, "What would you like me to read?" He said, "You can read it whatever you want." I chose to read the poem that is at the base of the Statue of Liberty by Emma Lazarus, which to me, that's the America that I know. And I think the extent to which that the candidates in the Democratic Party, my party, I'm a proud member, the extent to which they stick to true to themselves and true to those American values, I think that's good advice. I'm a big Cory Booker fan.
Sure.
He's my senator.
Okay.
Known him a long time. He's my guy, but I will stand with any of the Democrats, whoever it is that wins.
Is Trump beatable?
No question he's beatable, but it won't be easy.
Okay.
And I think if folks take it lightly, they'll pay a price for that. But without question, again, if they stick to themselves, who they are, and stick to American values, without question, he is beatable.
Governor, thank you for your time.
Great to be with you.
Appreciate you being in India.
My honor.
Thank you.
Really excited about it.
Thank you.
Thank you.